two ago, I thought I'd take a ride. And soon Miss Fanny Bright was seated by my side. The horse was lean and lame, misfortune seemed his lot. He got into a drifted bank and then we got upset.
Too much of this fast drying agent into this full paint. Also, you can't really pull off what I do with a palette knife very well because it becomes too thinned out and too slippery on the canvas. And you could also increase the dry time on your canvas by adding some a little rag with some paint thinner on it. But again, I can't really do that with what I do because it'll make it too slick. Not to mention, I don't want to deal with all the fumes. When I'm mixing this, I wish I could show you. Sorry, got stuff on my hands. Start with the light whites and yellows and mix it in. And each time I go from one lighter color to the next, I don't clean my palette knife. That way I sort of, what's called cutting the paint. Anybody that's an exterior, interior house painter or whatever, you know what I'm talking about. A lot of people actually in fine arts don't know what I'm talking about when I say cutting it. I remember having a professor ask me, what does that mean? Just think of a very small amount of mix. Between two different colors. Not a lot difference, just enough to change it slightly. Just cutting it a little bit. Almost done with my pre-mix here. Then I'll get started. Hope everybody's having a good weekend. Every time it rains, I just get really energized to come into the studio and get some work done. Maybe it's because I can't do anything else outside, I don't know. Now, I've turned my phone around to record because I noticed that everything I was recording was showing me a left-hander. I'm not a left-hander, I'm actually a right-hander. People were asking why the final thing was opposite of what they'd been watching. That's why. Almost done. Alright, so let me just check my camera before I get started. Hey, Ben. Hello. All right. So what I wanted to do on this, taking it long ways up, is to create a landscape. Something very basic. Don't want to get a lot of detail in this. And I want my emphasis actually to be on one center tree and some footprints. I'm going to do something I don't like to do a lot, and that's bring the horizon pretty far up. Or maybe I should bring it up way up. No, that's too much. All right, so I'm just going to make a little line across here so I know where my horizon is. And where's my stick? Make sure. I'm not going to make a lot of marks on this because I'm going to be creating this as I go. We're doing a sunset, but I'm not going to bring in a lot of colors. It's going to be just basically some yellows, keeping away from the reds and oranges too much in this one. All right, so first thing I need to do is build that sky in the back. So I'm not going to be talking a lot at this point, and I've had a migraine for about 2 weeks, so I'm not going to have a lot of music going in there. I did want to first add some whites in this area, just to base that. So when I put my yellows in, it won't be too overbearing of yellows. Trying to think how I'm going to do this sky part here without what an interesting, but not so interesting that you look at that instead of what I want you to look at. I'm going to dull this down just a little bit. When I have my yellow, it sort of muddies it up a little. I wasn't going to be talking much, and here I'm talking about. Instead of small marks, I think I'm going to opt to go straight across. I don't know. I'll do it and see how it looks. I might scrape it all off and start over. Just blending in these now. I'll basically fade it out to some cobalt blue. The last blast of blue that you get before the sun goes down. My air conditioner is very loud today. When I put this dull yellow and these whites in here, you can tell when I start bringing this other yellow across, it starts to mix in really well. Sort of takes down the tone of the yellow, the saturation of the yellow. I'm gonna bring back in this sort of brownish yellow that I use. Start working it back in from this top. I don't want that yellow going in. It's a little dark. A little spice of this. Mixing a lot of my paints on the canvas. Get garbage in there, just clean it off. Start over. And most of this is going to be covered up right here that I'm doing, so I don't want to spend a lot of time on it. I know my lot of time is completely different than most artists. Keep the paint off my edges. Because I don't want this yellow to be too hot. We are doing a winter scene. Sometimes I have a tendency to make these things way too hot. Just because I love right there. I'm trying to tone it down a little bit. I'm using my larger palette knife to do this area. Take forever with my other palette. Alright. I want this cobalt blue up in this area to be much lighter. The mix here. What I'll do is I'll mix it down into this area. It should bring out like a little greenish, hopefully a gold green. And if I get too light, I can always come back. Yeah, that's too light in that area. Here that I'll use as mixing tool in just a second. I'll show you which one. Garbage in my paint. And I thought I had my palette pretty well clean. Some trash coming from somewhere. I'm like,
some of this stuff out.
Hope I didn't move it too far down where you can't see. So I've got an interesting sky. I think I could work with this. Putting a base of white on this. Yeah. Let me check and make sure I'm still in the frame here. Most of it in there now. Could just joining us, we're doing a, I'm doing a Christmas scene for Christmas shows coming up. Yesterday, try to get me in the mood for this, I watched National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation. Keep thinking about the beginning of the movie where they're going out to get their Christmas tree out in the woods. And Clark forgets his saw. Alright. I think I got enough white on here for right now. Let me get a little fast dryer in it. If you weren't here, this is what I use for my fast drying. I don't have time to let these things cure the way they need to. I had to add a little bit of this to it. It helps a little, especially with the ones that take forever to dry. Some of the reds and oranges. And whites. And my blues and browns, they can grow without it. And if you don't know much about painting, you're using oil paints. They don't dry like acrylics. You have to wait for them to cure. And to cure properly takes months. I don't have months. I've got a month and a half. So I can use drying agents. And I know you might be wondering why am I putting white on white. It's because when I blend in my cobalt, it'll help keep it a little lighter than I can always work darker. You're working with a palette knife, you want to work from your lights to your darks. And you can always, after it dries, come back and hit some highlights. But if you do like I do where I want it to stand out with proper lighting and sort of pop a little bit more, I come back and add my accent whites at the very end. Okay. I got my base whites on there. All right. It actually comes down to the point where I actually start creating some stuff. So this is going to be further back. I need to lighten that up. Cobalt. Snow, the further away it is, it's going to look a little lighter, bluish. We are dealing with water. So. I'm going to get what I think is the white cobalt. Putting in this darker one for contrast purposes. I'll probably change this a little bit later, but right now I don't even know what that is. Just about to go down. And I've switched over to a different size palette now too. Well, if I was going to be able to see this really clear, I would probably take this out even further, but I'm not going to worry about it because it's mostly been covered up. Picking up some paint right now because I don't like it. Just a much lighter right here. Incorporate orange. I mean the yellow, excuse me. I'll come back and add more to it later. All right. Now we gotta start adding some far background trees. For this, I have some Haynes Gray, one background, Missouri Blue. Excuse me, my sinuses. I'm just going to add some trees down in this area right here. All I'm worrying about right now is trunks, branches. Because I want this to be coming through clouds. I mean, trees. map out my basic composition on this part. Dealing with something right in front of the light, it sort of breaks apart real easy. It's a glare from the sun around it. And as it goes out, it's more defined. Thick one there. Alright, now this is going to be the boring time. I'm going to do a lot of little things here. Change palette knives. And I'm just using the edge of my palette knife. I think I got too much medium in this. Again, I'm not trying to make these look exactly like trees. I want something exactly like a tree. I'll take a picture of a tree. I'm trying to get a feeling. Simple picture. time.
see how this looks in the video. Alright, so that's pretty much my background. Probably come back and touch up a few things. So, and since I didn't really completely come up with what I was going to do, now I'm at a standpoint for just a second to figure out what to do. We could have a little path coming through here, a few people walking. They walked back to the sunset, maybe they're walking, or maybe they've gone there. Through this area. I did want to put a really larger scale tree right here. I'm gonna put it right here. So I'm just gonna, this is where you just throw all caution to the wind. You mess up, right? But I'm making a tree really close. I'll use the side of my palette knife. And so let's start. I want to pull away this paint. So I can lay down my thicker paint. Save that paint. Maybe I can mix it with something. That way when I do my tree, paint just lays on there better. So now we got a tree with some character here. Yeah, I like that tree. Needs a little bit more strength right here, so we gotta make it wider. first snow flow. Let's go ahead and construct the tree. So even though I don't use black, I do mix sort of my own dark color. But it still has color in it. Even in shadows, there is color, as great homies. Some more. I'm gonna need a lot here. So my emphasis is going to be pretty much the tree and the footprints. Well, human element. And I let you know that people have been in this area. You know, I like doing strictly landscape for a lot of people. I like to see the human element. I actually like sometimes not to. Oftentimes in real life when you see the human element, if they're forming something on the ground. Too wide there. Probably should have picked up some dark lines out there. Not this stuff is so bad. I have to stop this and come back to this one. Go ahead and do what I can. Thank you. Alright, so I'm going to come back to this because I'm going to go get some more white. That can't go on from here without some more white. Yep. Alright, so I'll pick this back up in about an hour or so. Out of white. Let's see if there's any left. Maybe I don't have these. Let's see if I can. I had another white. Let's see what. I'm going to keep going just a little bit longer. I got a little bit more white. Maybe I can stretch it out. With using a palette knife approach that I do, you'll do a lot of paint. About a two per painting. I'll come back to this tree later, add more snow and stuff like that. So I need to have those little footprints coming through. Let's see if we start back here. And that paint that I pulled off of this earlier, really come up with some good colors. And they weren't by themselves. Had somebody coming along with them. Make these believable as footprints, you gotta add a lot of different shadows going on here, light areas. Disturbed snow. Let's see. So this would be kicking up snow on this side, creating a small. creating a lot of impasto here, a lot of texture. You can feel like sort of a cross between a sculptural piece and a painting. As painters, what is sculpture? I'll tell you, it's that thing you back up into when you're trying to get a good look at a painting. And ask the sculptor, what is a painting? They'll tell you that thing that gets in the way when you're trying to back up to see your sculpture. I think I heard that from Breed of Myatt. I forget where. How's everybody going? Is anybody here? Hey, Tammy. All right. Sorry, I haven't been looking at my camera. See who's been saying what or anything. Who's here, who's not here. Okay, so at this point, I gotta look at this and figure out if there's something else I want to put here or not. I don't want to do too much because it is a landscape painting. Start adding too much, get away from it. So, what do you guys think so far? What does that feel like? Feels like a couple of teenagers walking through the forest, Christmas time. Probably out at grandma's house.
I do see somewhere I need to add a little bit more shadow. That's coming going off that little.
Way it feels a little bit deeper snow. Pick some of these. Feels like a path they've walked down a few times, doesn't it? Maybe to go down here and see a sunset. I want to put a sign right here for some reason. Or how about if it's a the end part of a fence, like it's you're leaving the property. You're going off down this little path. Or maybe it's a boundary between your property and another property. You're leaving Grandma's farm. Let's see. Let me think. I'm waiting for the feeling to tell me what it needs. Go back through here. Still debating on the fence here. Trying to imagine it. Right, so we have a post sticking up about right here. I don't know if I want to do that. And yeah, I think I do want to do that, but I've got to get some more ones. Oh, found a one I forgot about. I knew I had another white here somewhere. I think I might have enough. All right. Let's see if I can get enough white out of this thing. I have no idea what time it is. Oh yeah. Yeah. I got enough white to finish this. And then some. Great. Alright, so I think at this point, we need to give it a place other than just the forest. And I'm going to switch over to a different palette knife. All right. Now, because I'm going to add snow to the wood, I need to make a little bit more blue over here. For contrast, I'm going to put the white on the post. So, I draw my posts. Grandma's fence is going to stop about right here. Post there. Post in this area. Scrape off just enough paint where I can get my color in there. That distance is not right. This is the bad part about just painting and figuring out your drawing first, but that's okay. I don't want that's too much. it's throwing me off. Like, this is so close. All right, so.
Alright, I can deal with that.
Alright. Let's see now.
I don't want to go too brown.
Like this is
older wood. So we got that gray look to it. Mix it up some here. There we go. Thank you.
on some snow.
That's why I included more of that blue. Keep getting paint on my glasses. Got on my nose too.
All right, so let's get some snow.
First, how deep is this? We'll get it right here on top of the post first. Work my way down. There's also going to be snow. Have to run that hole. So now we've created this fence. Has some snow on it. Build a shadow fence onto the snow. There we go. Need a little bit more contrast right here with this. There we go. How's everybody doing? Hey, Brandon. So, this is what I've created today. And, pretty happy with it. Sometimes I just need to give it more time to see if it needs anything else. It'll tell me, I'm sure. All right, guys. I'm gonna wrap this up for now. I'm hungry. I've had cereal all day, so. Thank you for stopping by and checking it out. All right, guys. Y'all have a great day.